What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Hold on a second, let me turn on my car. So it's cold, but yeah, welcome back. I feel like I always start videos from my car 95% of the time, but as you can see by the title, today's video is my talk I gave at Life Teen this past weekend. I was really nervous, and I actually got a couple mixed up for one of the things, but you know what? I'm hoping that I was able to get to the teens through this message that I gave. And so yeah, we have a video, we videoed it. Now I apologize for the quality being a little rough. We got my message through, and yep. So with that, we're gonna jump on into the video.
She's going to be talking to you tonight about our subject, okay? We don't know why it's on the screen.
There you go.
All right.
Hi, guys.
What's up?
So,
woo-hoo!
I don't normally speak in crowds, and I was really shocked when I decided to do this life night. So, here we go. So, question. What do you do when you get a brand new car?
Drive it.
Do you take care of like both the outside of the car and the inside? Just the outside? Or just the inside? So I try to do my best with both. Unless it's raining, then the car wash can wait because it's pointless. Alright, so now how about our soul and our body? Do we treat that like that brand new car? Sort of, maybe, right? Yeah, kind of. So, keyword in this is try. Kind of, I try to take care of my body and my soul as much as I can. With my body, like I try to exercise, I try to like eat healthy. So I know that I'm gluten and dairy and soy intolerant, but I don't always go by that. So. There's that. So, do you guys ever have times in your life where you're like, you know, you're doing great, you're like, yeah, I'm exercising, like, this is great, and then you are tempted with like a piece of chocolate cake or your favorite cake or something like chocolate?
Yeah.
Yes.
I support that.
Oh, yeah. So, do we eat it all, or do you just be like, no, I don't need that cake? It's just going to stay there. Taking care of our soul, we're not talking about just taking care of it part of the time. I'm talking like, do we try to take care of it all the time? Now, do we, our bodies, our minds, and our souls are so precious that we, you know, we need to make sure that we are taking care of all of these. And because in the end, I know for like my goal is to go up into heaven. I'm pretty sure that's everybody's goal in here. Am I wrong?
You are right.
So, the real question is, what are you going to do to help you reach that goal every day? Like, how are you going to help you get to heaven day by day until you go to meet with God? Okay. So, here's a thought. When we take care of not only our bodies, but our minds and souls too, we're able to A, live longer, duh. But, but B, we're also able to project the living word of God a lot longer too. Because I know that's something I want to try to do more and longer anyways. And like in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 19 through 20, it pretty much says, are you aware that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit? You were bought at a price. Glorify the Lord in your body. So, talking about our body being a temple of the Holy Spirit, right? In a sense. So everybody's aware of like what the monstrance in, you know, the back of the altar is, right? Yeah. Anybody know what it holds?
The
Eucharist. The blessed Eucharist, right? So it's holding Jesus. The Latin symbol, right? So. So, this is a really dumb question, but when the body of our Lord Jesus Christ isn't in there, is it empty?
No.
Yeah, because Jesus isn't in there, so technically it's kind of empty. So, what do you think we are like without Jesus in our souls? I was scrolling through, I got a bunch of memes, but hopefully it's in the right order, but I see it like this. basically, that's what I see. Mass and just trying to take care of myself every day through prayer. Like, I got this devotional for Christmas that I've been reading every day, and it's fabulous. If you don't have one, I'd rather recommend grabbing one. So in the first book of Timothy, chapter 4, verses 4, it says that everything God created is good, that we should not decline any of it, but to accept it and to receive it today. Okay, so, okay, I have another question for you guys. So, has anybody read the first chapter of, like, the book of Genesis? At least once or twice, and knows what God did on the seventh day?
Yes.
Yes. Here's some answers. Anybody want to say it loud and proud?
He rested.
Exactly. So, how many of us actually take a day of rest? Like, I'm talking like no homework, or just like you literally do what God did and just took a rest. Doing that, we all have, we can find find some time to take care of ourselves too, correct?
Yes.
At least try to, at least, like I said, even if it's just 1 minute a day.
Yeah.
You guys liked it. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel down below, and definitely subscribe because I've got some good things coming within the next couple of months. So yeah, again, I apologize for this video coming up so late. There's just been a lot's been going on since that talk, even before that talk, a lot has gone on. But definitely subscribe because, like I said, some awesome stuff is coming up here in the next couple of months. So yeah, with that, I'm gonna end it off here. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. I love y'all so much. God bless, and as always, stay hungry, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.